Hello everyone, my name is Vladimir Enchev, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use Rdzen Blazor components in .NET 8 Blazor web application type newly added by Microsoft. So I have Visual Studio opened and I'm going to create a new project, Blazor web app. Press next. You can choose the application name. My is Blazor web app with Rdzen Blazor, and you can choose also the location of your application. Press next. Now you can choose various configurations for your application. We are going to use .NET 8. We are not going to have any authentication. We are going to use HTTPS. Interactivity render mode of the app is going to be WebAssembly, but you can choose server or auto. And interactivity will be global for all pages. And we are going to include some sample pages. Okay, press create. And now we have a new application created with some pages. And now we want to extend this application with some Blazor components from Rdzen. Okay, so here is the server application and here is the client application where we need to add a new dependency from NuGet. Okay, I'm going to use search to find the Rdzen Blazor NuGet package. We have over 5 million downloads already. Install the latest stable version. Okay. We're in here. Now you can follow our instructions on our getting started on how to add the rest of the configuration. Let's now import some namespaces. Rdzen and Rdzen Blazor. Okay. Now we need to add the CSS needed for our Blazor components. We can do that in our app page here. Okay. And we need also to add the JavaScript needed for the Blazor components. Again, copy from our getting started page. Okay, now we can add some code to check if everything works correctly. I'm going to extend, however, this with our dialog service. Okay, and the press of the button, going to call the alert method of the dialog service. However, to work properly, the dialog service, the context menu, the notifications, and etc., we need to add additional code to our main layout. This is Rdzen components track, and we need to also add to our services our extension methods. In order our services to be registered. Since the application is pre-rendered by default, we need to add the same in the server program CS file. Let's run now the application to check the result. Okay, waiting for Visual Studio to start the browser. And we are ready. We have Radzen button. And when you press it, it will show a message from our DAO service. Okay, that's all for now. Thanks for watching.